jetzt einige Leute rausgekommen, neue kommen rein, nach und nach. Und zwar geht es jetzt erstmal die nächste Stunde um Open Source Design. Ich frage mich ja immer, was ist das eigentlich Open Source Design? Man kann ja immer sehen, was für Farben da stehen, irgendwie egal, was jemand für ein Design macht und wie funktioniert das eigentlich, was ist die Idee dahinter? Dann werden wir jetzt mehr erfahren von einem Spezialisten, der das auch in einer Firma umsetzt. Jan Christoph, du arbeitest für Nextcloud hier in Berlin, praktisch die Weiterentwicklung von OwnCloud, ja, was ja auch schon viele kannten. Und ihr habt ja auch Open Design Community in eurer Firma. Da bin ich natürlich ganz gespannt, was da für neue Entwicklungen gibt. Also herzlich willkommen hier, Jan-Christoph Borchert beim Open Tech Summit. Herzlich willkommen.
Danke. Ja, ich würde gerne den Vortrag auf Englisch machen. Hat da jemand was dagegen oder kann jemand, versteht jemand überhaupt kein Englisch? Dann bitte Hand hoch. Nee? Okay, ist alles okay? Super, okay. Okay, so I'll talk to you about open source design today, present to you the open source design community and what initiatives and projects there are doing open source design. And throughout the whole day, actually, there will be, there's an open source design track. So there will be talks, for example, by Ilio from Mozilla and by Jan from Wikimedia and a bunch of other people who are doing design in open source or in the open in various different ways. So I'm going to give a quick overview to kind of kick off the topic at Open Tech Summit. So first of all, open source design, we're a broad community, an open collective of designers and developers, and we're pushing more open design processes in open source software. Also in free software, the name is just, it's just a naming thing, so it's free and open source design actually. So it's just that the naming free software design is kind of confusing with getting software design for free. So that's our website, opensourcedesign.net. And as you can see on the top already, we do a few things. So we write articles, for example, we run a job board, we put on events, and have different things like resources and just try to bring together designers in open source. So a few of the things we do. One thing, as I said, articles. Recently we had a good article about our open source design needs better collaboration tools. We have an interview series with designers in open source. Then we have a bunch of events like a regular meetup in Berlin, actually. And we do actually a regular open source design track at FOSDEM. FOSDEM, you probably know, it's one of the biggest open source conferences, and it's in Brussels. And we do that since 3 years now. So, we successfully brought more design into like one of the geekiest open source conferences, which I think is quite cool. And we're also at other conferences like FOS North, and we also had an open source design track at FOS Asia, actually. And now here also, so I'm very happy about that. And another thing we do is the job board. So if you actually have an open source project and you need design help, you can just open a job there. You can just fill out a form and put in what you need. If you need a logo, if you need web design, if you need layout, usability testing, you can just fill it out and put in the info, and then people can help you. And also, it's for projects big and small. So Wikimedia or Mozilla or LibreOffice Document Foundation, they put jobs there, but also smaller projects like, small project just wanting a logo, for example. But there's also paid projects, actually. So if you're actually a designer, first of all, join our community, and you can also check out the jobs that there are and try to get involved there. So these are just some of the projects which are which have designers involved in our community or of which our community consists. So for example, Wikipedia or Wikimedia, Mozilla, WordPress, Taiga, which you might not all know. Taiga is an open source project management system. Then GitLab, an open source GitHub. Nextcloud, which I'm working on, GNOME also, the open source desktop environment, Drupal, and LibreOffice also. And there's a bunch more projects of which the designers are in our community. So we have a group on GitHub with 400 people or so. And so it's just a hub for designers and also developers which are design-minded. So here is our GitHub organization, and there we also have our website, we have the jobs board, so if you find any issues, you can just directly fix it or open an issue about it. And we try to also be where, we try to kind of bridge this gap between design and open source development. So we also need to be present on GitHub and want to kind of find out like which platforms designers can use and in which platforms designers and developers can meet. So this is one of the approaches we take. And for example, with Nextcloud, all the design discussion is also happening in the issues. So directly at the developers, like where we post mockups, for example, and we have discussions. So yeah, that's a very good tool for that. This is our Twitter account. There you see a photo from the last FOSDEM open source design dev room. So yeah, this is also just a few of the people who are involved in our community. And it's at OpenSRC Design if you want to check out any updates or what we're up to. And yeah, as I said, it's a very open community. So we have like, I don't know, 10 or 15 people who are tweeting from that account and are roughly involved in that organization. And then the job board, as I was saying earlier, these are the latest jobs actually. So there's like some small design jobs for example, from the FSFE, they look for a designer who uses Scribus for printouts or emojis, or at the bottom you have LibreOffice, for example. And so you can just look through, there's some jobs big and small, and it's perfect for both open source projects and designers who look for jobs. And we're trying to improve that even more by, for example, categorizing the jobs into like branding and logo design, web design, interaction design, usability and research and stuff like that. And if you want to get involved, please do. We're a very open community. And to that extent, we also recently opened a forum, which is Discourse, which is an open source forum software. And you can find that at discourse.opensourcedesign.net. And it recently started, and there's a bunch of nice discussion, for example, on, we have a few categories, for example, general communication and collaboration between designers and developers. Then we have local meetups. For example, there's a local meetup in Berlin, and there's one starting in Madrid. And probably we're kicking off one in London, and hopefully other places also. And then we have a category for logo design and branding. Then, for interaction design, usability and research, anything that pertains to design and open source, basically. And this is, for example, or this is the example of our first open source design dev room. So we have like a whole day of talks, people from Drupal, people from Media Goblin, people from the UK Open Data Network, and a bunch of other people. Last time we had people who were working on accessibility, people who were working on in the GNOME project, on LibreOffice, like if. Bunch of different talks. So if you're at FOSDEM in Brussels next year, I hope we'll be accepted again. And then please drop by. And if you're a designer, please hand in a talk. We're always looking for good talks. And of course, we're also here at the Open Tech Summit. So very happy that Mario invited us to do this open source design track. So as said, after me, for example, Ilio will talk about the Mozilla rebranding, which I think is quite interesting, as it also happened very recently, and it was an open rebranding process. So I think that's also very interesting to learn. Then I'm just going to give you a few examples of if you want to get better design right now by yourself and you're a developer, or you're just working on any project, to give a few tips. For example, there's this website called The Noun Project. It's just for icons, openly licensed icons of any kind. So you can just, it's called The Noun Project because they aim to have an icon for any noun. So if you look for an icon for a fridge or a conference or a laptop, you will just find a bunch of icons. And for example, I also upload my icons there, and you can license them either Creative Commons attribution or public domain. I think there might be also other licenses, but those are basically, most icons are licensed under those two licenses. So that's quite cool because you can just use them with attribution or in some cases even without. Then another thing is the font library or the open font library. It's if you need a typeface that you can use for anything, then yeah, you can check out the Open Font Library, and there's a bunch of really nice typefaces there. And you might know already that actually Google Fonts, they have their website, they also have only openly licensed fonts, so that's quite cool, I think, and it's quite a big assortment of typefaces. And then for pictures, there's a whole ton of these websites cropping up, which are licensing or which have as a guideline that all the pictures on them are licensed as CC0, so in public domain. And these are just two examples, so unsplash.com and pexels.com. So if you need any kind of photos for any illustrations or for any websites, any stock photos, you can just check them out, and they're actually pretty good. So for example, for our Nextcloud website, we use some pictures from these websites, and they're pretty nice and all CC0. So that's quite cool. And of course, I mean, also Flickr has a pretty good Creative Commons search. So if you don't find something there, you can also search on Flickr, and also other sites which you might not even know about, like SoundCloud or other YouTube, for example, have good Creative Commons licensing, so you can just check them out actually. And another thing which often isn't done too much, and how I also got involved in the whole open source design thing, is usability testing. And so, for example, this is a thesis I wrote like 7 years ago now, about usability in free software, usability testing in the context of free software, where there's not much time, there's not much resources. You can't really pay someone necessarily for every project. And so you have to keep it very lean and very useful. So this is a guide I wrote, which is available on my website, which tries to help people who work in open source projects, also as developers, just as an intro for these kinds of things. And I know there's a bunch of resources from all kinds of open source projects, which are on our website, which are linked, and which you can also check out if you have a project. And actually tomorrow we'll have a meetup at Cbase at 7 p.m. So if you're around, you can just come. Cbase is at Janowitzbrücke, you probably know the place anyway. And then also in Berlin at Wikimedia and at Mozilla, most probably, we're gonna have the Open Source Design Summit. It's the first Open Source Design Summit. So we're not at another conference, but we have our dedicated summit, and it's going to be in October 13th till 18th. So yeah, if you're around then, or if you want to participate, if you want to help, then please come and please talk to us. We're around, Jan and Elio and me and others, and please get involved. So as I said before, we have this discourse forum, and if you want to stay in touch, best just sign up there, discourse.opensourcedesign.net, or check out opensourcedesign.net or Twitter opensrcdesign. Thank you.
Okay, thank you very much. So we still have a few minutes for questions here. Yeah. So any questions, please join us here in front. There's a microphone, if you would like to know. Actually, where is the, maybe I have a few questions. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So what's the website again? I couldn't catch it so fast.
It's opensourcedesign.net. It says it there.
On the bottom.
Yeah.
Opensourcedesign.net. Okay, so I can look for jobs there, or I can find jobs, or I can put up jobs. So how does it work?
Yep. So I can actually show you. So I don't have internet right now, so I can't show you the form, but this is, for example, the job board. So it's just a list of jobs, and for example here, there's even jobs like art director at Drupal, for example, so even like paying jobs, Wikimedia, for example, but also smaller things like usability testing for a project, or logo design, for example.
Yeah. How long do these jobs then stay online?
It really depends. I mean, so for example, like actually one I scrolled by is actually already, like Elio actually did a logo for it, and so that's fixed already. But It really depends. That's also another thing what we need to improve is that we actually have like a right feedback process and that we know what happens with the job. And we would also like to have some case studies from how they did it, how they got it, and what was the end result. So this is actually something we need to improve. And we're also looking for people who are more developers who want to help us with that actually. So there's definitely with the job board, there's a bunch we can still improve also.
Okay, and did you already get some feedback of people who did some designs for open source projects?
Yeah, so I mean, for example, maybe Open Tech School, the meetup, regular meetup in Berlin, and they actually are looking, we're looking for, I think, Open Tech School. Yeah, general UX and UI for the website, and the organizer, she let me know that they actually found something through open source design, through the job board. This is another reason why we need to make this process nicer. Apparently there's a lot of people who get jobs through these sites or who get designers through the site. We just don't really know it yet.
That would be interesting. But so at the moment you don't yet know how is the success rate you hear, but like you're not collecting it.
We kind of know that there's a ton of things happening and there's things working also because, for example, sometimes there's discussions happening in our GitHub repositories around these things where people don't make a job post but rather an issue, and then we see the discussion, for example. So yeah, it's definitely successful. It's definitely working, and people are always very interested.
That's what I did. I just opened an issue in one of the repositories, and I don't use the form because I want the people to follow up immediately.
So what we're thinking about is actually combining it with the discourse, because there is apparently a way where you can embed a thread into a static page, and then we can have like a comment stream or whatever. And so that's also something we're looking
into. But then I need to create a new login for discourse.
But that's you should do that anyway.
Because of course, okay, but like you could also check out the integration with GitHub, for example, at Force Asia. We have an integration where you can see issues on the websites. Mm-hmm. That could be job posts. I don't know. Well, let's see, like different ways, different approaches, mm-hmm. and whichever approach is the most successful, we will all follow, right? So thanks a lot. Is there anyone who still has a question at this point? Maybe people are waiting for you because later on they know you have a workshop. At what time is your workshop?
I don't have a workshop actually, but Jan from Wikimedia has a workshop and Ilio has a workshop. So GitHub for Designers, I think, and paper prototyping. And there's also a Blender workshop, for example.
Yeah. So the Blender workshop, by the way, is in the tent. And they are also like our friends from Hong Kong with their tiny 3D printer. So you can print out if you make anything there. Yeah?
We have a question.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Microphone. Yeah.
Unfortunately, I arrived just. A question: are you also in contact with people who are working about eco design to make it to go together?
Eco design, you mean like with a low carbon footprint, or So that would be more for hardware design, right? Or
for all, I think.
Okay. I mean, not yet. So if you have any contacts, let's talk.
Okay. I think would be cool as you're traveling a lot around the world, your personal footprint probably not so good, neither is mine, I have to admit, but would be cool to make an open source design airplane with a better carbon footprint, right?
Maybe.
Let's aim high. So thank you very much for the inspiration, Jan Christoph, and we'll hear more about open source design in a moment. Thank you very much.
Thank you.